coming back this year? Is there one guy that we're not looking at that you see in that group that you think is going to stand out this year?
Cade Stewart.
Cade?
Gates or Lanka. Those two, you know, obviously, you know about Matt Bockhorst and Blake Benson, who we redshirted. You know, Blake probably could have gotten in there last year. Matt's knee wasn't quite ready. We wanted to make sure he would have made it, but we want to make sure he's 100%. No sense in risking. And you know, Blake came in January and got to go. I got a little work in, and so being able to hold him, just let him add bulk and strengthen his shoulder even more. His strength levels are way up now. And Matt benches over 400 pounds. He's been phenomenal. He's added great bulk.
So. Can you expand on Kate a little bit? Kate came out a little under-recruited.
He didn't have all them stars by his name, you know, and everybody probably slept on him a little bit, but he has a great sense of what's going on. You know, he's just a natural. He just steps up there. He don't seem to worry about a whole lot. You know, a lot of young people put a lot of stress on themselves some. He's cool, you know, jumps up there, plays center, goes over and plays guard, can play tackle, just wherever we need him. He's just a great company man. He's the epitome of an offensive lineman.
With John, what did you see from him, I guess, last year in the spring that gave you so much confidence that he's ready to go in and kind of take that next step?
Just knowledge. He's always had the strength and the ability, you know, but the knowledge has really come. And, you know, he's so tall sometimes it's a little bit harder at guard, learning to uncoil a little bit. But, you know, he's a powerful guy now. And, he's comfortable enough, he knowing what to do. He can move out there at tackle and do a great job. Not just a good job, a great job there too. And, you know, it's going to help him at the next level because he'll be able to play multiple positions.
What about Chandler?
Chandler had really come on. You know, Chandler tore his knee up, and he had to have the scope, but he has really made great strides. He is really coming on. I'm very proud of where he's at. And, he's bigger. He's over 300 pounds now, or close to it. And his strength levels have just really jumped. And he's long arm, so it's a little harder on him bench pressing. But now he's catching up. And I watched him in there yesterday, and it's impressive. He had his knee scoped and cleaned up. He tweaked it a little bit, so. He feels better. He said it's a little bit sore, but he's doing much better. You'll see things out of him.
What was your message to your unit after the Sugar Bowl, after we lost out there?
Sun's going to come up tomorrow.
No, it did?
Sun's going to come up. It'll be another day.
When you evaluated that game, what did you think of the play?
Some played well, some didn't. It's just like it is at every position. It's part of the job that we do. You know, everybody thinks it all starts there, and it does. And that's why we love doing what we do. We take full responsibility. And our group will be back.
Not only the offensive line, but you feel like the team kind of went into the offseason with maybe a bad taste in this mouth.
Well, I don't know about that. You know, there was a lot of accomplishments. As I said, coaches, we take it a lot harder than they do. They can bounce back. They're a little more resilient than we are. But I know for me, I remember losses. I don't remember wins. You know, this is what we do. It's kind of sad. It's sad in this business. But that's the way it is. There'll be another day.
Coach, looking to the season in the ACC and specifically the schedule, is there a defensive line unit that you kind of like pinpointed as one that's going to be troublesome for you this year on the schedule?
I know you don't believe it, but I don't know who we play past the first three games. I just kind of, only reason I know those three is because we start making preparations and start breaking down and trying to get a little bit going, but I've been doing it long enough. What difference does it make? I ain't gonna change it. We're gonna have to beat them, whatever it is. So, I think all players are good, and I'm gonna face them the same way. We're gonna prepare, you know, to win the game. But I know there's some great defensive linemen in this league. But what I have to face every day, shoot. Listen, we see every blitz known to man from day one. The games usually end up being easier when we get through with practice each week. So.
Daniel Stone used to refer to you as a redneck Jesus. How do you feel that you put that on your
I don't know what that means.
Your messages. Yeah, it's good. Your messages refer back to Jesus and your faith, but you put it in layman's terms. How do you feel?
Well, I'm a simple-minded guy. That's why I try to teach life lessons as we go through this. They get sick of hearing it, but it's amazing that when they finish, they always use it. And, just like it was handed down to me, I've tried to do the same thing. I've always taught by telling stories. The problem is, it's harder. These kids don't know John Wayne. They don't know Muhammad Ali. They don't know George Foreman. You know, they know George Foreman's real, but they don't. So it's a little bit harder. I have to learn, you know, some of the things that they know now. And it's reversed. It used to be hard for them. Now it's hard for me. So.
Who do you feel taught you?
Well, all my coaches, particularly Coach Bill Few in high school. You know, he was a mentor. And of course, Coach Sheridan, who I played directly for. Coach Art Baker. There's so many of them. I mean, I can go on and on. But, you know, I try to learn from everybody. Some of the best guys, like my first speaking engagement, it was a 79 high school clinic. I look on the front row and there's Coach McKissick, Coach Babb, and Coach Varner all sitting right there. Now, you youngsters, y'all don't even know who that is. And it's a shame, because if you're a sports writer, you need to know who those people are in this state. But those are legends. And they're sitting there listening to me. I'm 23 years old up there speaking. And I was in awe. I could not believe it. But those are the people that I learned from. I take from everybody, to be honest with you, because it's all handed down.
Let's jump on recruiting for a second. Do you feel like offensive line is maybe the hardest position to recruit and maybe to project how a guy's going to turn out in college because the body's changed so much?
It could be. To me, I know what I want. I know what I'm looking for. And it's getting harder to find because of the game that we play today. There's so much throwing. And that's a wonderful thing. Don't get me wrong, I'm not kidding you. But, it's complete reverse from when I started. You used to have to teach everybody how to pass block. Now you have to teach them how to run block. So the game's kind of changed, and you play in from a two-point stance a lot. Sometimes I get young people that's never been in a three-point stance now, which was really odd, but it's just part of it, and you have to learn to adjust. So you make a good point. That would be a good argument somewhere.
And what are you looking for when you look at that?
Well, I don't know how much time we got for all, but being able to step equally well with either foot, you know, being able to use his hands, being able to arch his back, get flat back stance, being able to keep his eyes up, you know, all those things are hard, and you're not sure how much is being taught sometimes. And can they run? How do they play away from the ball? When the play's going the other way, do they work hard, give effort? And it's a little bit difficult sometimes at the lower levels because you may not have a one or two coaches coaching the whole team sometimes. They can't watch everything. The luxury we have at the college level is there's a position coach for every position, so every group. So your eyes are always on them. I got to be the first to tell you, I never shut up. I coach all, every snap, every play, and you know, it's something that they're not used to.